वेलकम एवरीवन, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एडवांस फीचर इन एमएस एक्सेस एंड वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द मास्टर टेबल कंसेप्ट. इन मास्टर टेबल विच कंटेन्स द डाटा विच वी डू नॉट फ्रीक्वेंटली चेंज एंड द ट्रांजेक्शन डाटा विच फ्रीक्वेंटली चेंज. सो देर आर द अदर वेरियस डिफरेंट फीचर्स ऑफ एमएस एक्सेस विच आर इम्पोर्टेंट एंड वी विल लर्न अबाउट देम. First of all, we will open MS Access. We have to click on the start button. Then here is the shortcut or what, how we can go. We can click on the all programs. Then the Microsoft Office. And then MS Access. Now we can give the name to our database here. This one is advanced features or advanced. So here we are going to give the name and then create. So we have created the database with the name advanced. Let's make some data so that we can learn about the searching of data, how we can search. A, C, D, D, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, R, S, T, U, P, W, X, Y, Z. I have put it some data in field 1 so that we can learn how to search the data. To search the data, we have a search box exactly at the bottom of your active sheet. This is the active sheet and the data is here, the search box is here and the bottom it is written search. So here we have whatever data we want to search, we can search it here. So for suppose I have to search A, B, C, D. Automatically it highlighted the text which I have written on the search box. So this is the very easy way to search the data. For suppose I have written it has shown this. This is highlighted. Whatever you will write in search box, it will highlight the item. So this is the way to do the search. See, again it has given the search. And if we want to the another one, I have written Ankit in two columns just because if we want that, if you will feel that the data is in more than one cell, then we can click on the next and from here at the left of the search box you can see here the next and it will send it to the next part. So this is how we can have the different this is how we can move to the different cell. This is also one of the most important features of the Excel. Now if you want to do the calculation, how you will do the calculation in Excel? In Excel it is very easy, but now in Excel we will learn how we will do the calculation. For calculation we must have some digits or number and we should have the data in data sheet view. This is because as you know in design view we only design our data. In data sheet view we can do the calculation. For suppose I am putting some digits here. Any of the digit by your choice you can input. And then we can learn how we can do the calculation in data sheet. So to do the calculation, first I have entered some data, that is digits data. So now for to do the calculation, what we have to do, we have to select the home tab. In home tab we have here this total function. We have to click on total. When we click on the total, you will see here that total is written. When you will find that in this column in field 1, you will see name and none and count. Here is the count, just because there is nothing to do the calculation and count is 9. So you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In 9 of the rows there are the items, so the count is 9. Here we have the data. So in data you will see this bar, in this arrow, you have to click on this arrow. When you will click on this arrow, you will see here some average. Count, maximum, minimum, standard deviation and variance. So here you will find different functions. For this, like if you will click on none, nothing will happen. Sum 45, you can do the counting. 2 plus 3, 3, 6, 6, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 15, 21, 28, 36, 36 plus 9, 45. So the total is 45. We can use different function from here, from this list. Now if you want the average, you can click on the average. You can see here the 5. Just because 9 items are there and the total is 45. 45 divided by 9 is 5. And you can see the average 5. So like in Excel, we have to put the formulas. Like you have learned in the previous year, you have to put the formulas again and again by using the equal to sign. First you have to do the summation, then you have to do the average. But Excel provides you the different function by which you can directly do the calculation. Just put the formula and the calculation will be done. Like here, I am showing you again average. Now if you want to do the count, click on count. It has given the count 9, 1 the sum 45, maximum 9. See the maximum digit is 9, so it has shown us the maximum digit 9. And this, like this, we can have the minimum also. 1, you can see here 1 is the minimum value and 9 is the maximum value. So it has given both minimum also and maximum 2. Standard deviation 2.7. we don't need the formula of standard deviation. Variance is 7.5. so all this we can do in a data sheet. In data sheet view, in left hand side you can see here it is a data sheet view. Data sheet view, we can use the different function by using the total. Here we can use the total and then we can use the different function available in total. So after this we have this feature, we have the filtering in data sheet. That is also a very important feature, filtering in data sheet. Now we will learn how we will do the filtering in data sheet. Okay, let's open a new table. That we have to create a table. Let's create a new table. And now we will learn how we will do the filtering. To filter the data, first we have to write some data. Let's write. We have to enter some data. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N. I'm entering some of the data here, so that we can learn how we can filter our data. That means how we can get the data by our choice. Whatever data we want, we can have the data as per our choice. So after this, we have the different features by which we can have the filtered data. That is, first one is we can have by selecting the all. After selecting, we can do the, after selecting all the items, we can do the right click, and here we have the text filter option. And in text filter option, you can see equals, does not equals, begin with, does not begin with, contains, does not contain, ends with, does not end with are there. If you want to equal to sign, field 1 equals, and you can write like cd. Okay, the data which is in cd only, that is there. You can see other data which is not equal to cd been removed. And you can see here at the top of the field where the field is written, the filter sign is already made. By clicking on it, you can get the checkbox. In this checkbox, you can see we only the CD check is there. Checkbox only a check mark is there on CD option. Now, if you want the other data back, then you have to select all and then click on OK. All the data will be returned. So one part is this is how you can filter the data, and another is in a home tab you have this filter option at the top. In shortened filter group, in shortened filter group, you will click on the filter, you will automatically get this list, and this is the checkbox again, and according to your choice you can mark any of the row. Like if I want KL or MN, I will click on MN, then OK, only the MN list will be there. And if you want the checkbox again, click on the filter option again and you will get check filter. So you can select all and click on OK, then you will get your data back. Similarly, here also in number filters, you can put the number filters. Does not equal to, greater than, less than. Like if you want the greater than or of, greater than 230, if you will write greater than 30 and click on OK, all the number which are greater than 30 will appear. So it is a totally up to your choice how you can do the filter option. This is how you can use the filter. Now you have sorting. Sorting means arranging the data either in ascending or descending order. Like here we have the data which we want to sort, 10 20 30 40 50 60 70. Okay, to sort the data in the same way you have sort if done the filtering, what you can do, you can select the data from here. You can hit the field, and after selecting this, you can see at the top short smallest to largest, short largest to smallest. It already I have written smallest to largest. You can do shorting from largest to smallest, and see the data is converted, or you can say shorted. So through the tab menu, you can select the data and you can have this. Another way of sorting is, you can see here in the tab descending, already data is in descending form. You can click on ascending and data is sorted in ascending. If your data is in text form, you have this ascending and descending option here also. So even in the text or it is a number, you can use the filter option. From home tab, shorten filter group. This is how we will do the shorting in MS Access. So this is the very important part, filtering and shorting. Now other is importing the data from the other application like MS Excel and other. We have to click on the external data. From the external data, we have Excel option here. We can select the Excel option, and then it is asking about the files or the documents where from where we have to import the data. So from where we have to import the data, we have to check that and we have to browse the location. If there is no sheet, then it is not asking. Like if I want the book one, we have to click on the book one and then open. Now we have given the actual address. We have to browse the address from where we want our data, and then click on open, and then it will show the OK option. And now it is written import the source. So then after that, click on OK, and we have this sheet, and in which we have this items. It is showing all the items, and there are the three sheets in there. Second one is blank and third one is blank. Only sheet one have the actual data. So it is showing us this, and then we have to click on the next button, and then the first row contain the column setting. We can check or not, and after that we have to again click on the next button, again click on the next button, and let's access add primary key. As you all know, primary key is very important. Other if there is no primary key, the data, we can't make the table in Access. So automatically it will add the primary key. Then we have to finish the checkbox, and then it will automatically edit this into our sheet. So we don't have the split option. So it is asking to save the import here. It has created the another sheet one table here. We get the sheet one. This is the sheet one which is there in the imported data. This sheet we have imported from Excel. Excel contain this sheet, and we have imported it in our Access. This is how you have to import the data from another table. First you have to go in Excel, then you have to browse the table, which table you want, the Excel, whatever Excel table you have. And after clicking on it, you can do the OK button, and then you have to click on the next, and after that you have to click on finish, and then this sheet will be open like this. So this is your advanced features. Now you have to learn this, and I am going to provide you the exercise. Do the exercise in the notebook, complete your work, and as soon as possible you have to learn all the theory part, and soon we will have a test in our meetings. So please watch the previous videos also, and keep learning. Thank you.